Now let us briefly discuss multiplexers or data selectors. Now multiplexers, usually referred to as MUCs or data selectors, they are actually used to select a particular input, right? So basically you have many inputs. A MUX will have many inputs and would have one output. Now since we have many inputs, at a particular time instant, I need to select one of the inputs which would appear at the output. So therefore, we also need a select line. Right? So if I consider a MUX, right? So there is one output and we have select lines. Now if I have one select line, so let me call this as S0. S0 can either be 0 or 1. So when it is 0, I can select one of the inputs. So let me call that as I0. And when S0 is 1, I can select another input. Let me call this as I1. Right? So if I have one select line, I would have 2^1 number of inputs. So the number of select lines would actually indicate the number of inputs I have. I have two select lines, 2^2, which is 4, would be the number of inputs. So how many inputs would I have? I would have 2^2 number of select lines, right? So if I have two select lines, it would be 2^2 inputs. If I have three select lines, I would have 2^3 inputs, which is 8. And of course, I would have one output. So let us begin with a very simple 2:1 MUX. So I have a 2:1 MUX. So this indicates that there are two inputs and one output, and definitely we have one select line. So let us draw the truth table and let us see how a 2:1 MUX can be implemented. So what is a truth table? So the select, this is the select line S0. And let me call the output as Y. So the output is Y. So when the select line S0 is 0, I get I0. So I0 is connected to the output. So whatever is present at I0 will appear at the output. If I0 is 0, I get a 0 here. If I0 is 1, I would get 1 here. Next, when S0 is 1, I would get I1. Right, so this is a very simple way of implementing it. So now how can this be, this is a very simple truth table of a 2:1 MUX. So how can this be implemented? So we have two inputs, I0 and I1. Right? So I need to select one of them. So definitely I would have an OR gate and one output Y. Correct? So now I have one select line S0, which is used to select either I0 or I1. So I have one select line S0. So when S0 is 0, I need to select I1. So what do? I pass this through an inverter. So when I pass this through an inverter, you get a 1 here. When S0 is 0, I get a 1. Right? So when I have a 1 here, whatever is at I0 will appear at the output of the AND gate. Right? So when S0 is 0, this is 1. So if I0 is 0, I get a 0 here. If I0 is 1, I will get a 1 here. So next, when S0 is 1, I need I1 at the output. So what do? We connect S0 and I1 directly to another AND gate and pass it to the input of an OR gate. So let us see what happens here. Where S0 is 1, when S0 is 1, the output of the inverter is 0. So I have a 0 here. So we know that if any one of the inputs of an AND gate is 0, output is always 0, right? So this is 0, so this is always 0. Okay, so if this input is 0, I get a 0 here. If this input is 1, I get a 1 here. So if I have a 2 input OR gate and if one of the input is 0, then the output depends on the other input. Right? So thereby, when this is 1, right, so this input is disabled. So now when this is 1, if I0 is 0, I get a 0 here. So definitely Y will be 0. If I1 is 1, I would get a 1 here. So I1 is connected to Y. So this is a very simple way of implementing a 2 is to 1 mux. So now let us see how a 4 is to 1 mux works. So as we have already stated, a 4 is to 1 mux will have 4 inputs and 2 select lines and one output. So we have a 4 is to 1 mux, one output Y, two select lines S0 and S1, and definitely we have 4 inputs I0, I1, I2 and I3. So these two select lines will determine the selection of the inputs. When S0 and S1 is 0, I have I0 being selected, right? So this is, so let me write S0 here and S1 here, because S0 is the LSB, S1 is the MSB. So when these two are 0, 0, I have I0 being selected, 0, 1, I1 being selected, 1, 0, I2 being selected, 1, 1, I3 is selected. So I have two select lines, S1, S0. So they can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So what about the output? The output is Y. So in the first case, I0 is selected, I1, I2 and I3. Very simple, right? So we have four lines, input lines, so I have I0, I1, I2 and I3. Okay, so one of these four inputs are selected, so therefore I use a four input OR gate. Okay, there are two select lines S0 and S1. And definitely we need 4 AND gates for selection. So in the first case, when S0 and S1 is 0, we need to select I0. So all these 3 have to be disabled, that means the output should be 0. So for S1 and S0, when they are 0, I need to have a 1 here. The select line in select line S1, pass it through an inverter and connect it to one of the inputs of an AND gate. So when S1 is 0, this is going to be 1, so I have a 1 here. When S0 again is 0, pass it through another inverter, right? So this again will be 1, and I0 is connected. So this is 1, this is 1. So the output definitely depends on I0. If I0 is 0, I get a 0 here. If I0 is 1, I get a 1 here. And all these 3 would be disabled. So we'll see that. So I connect this to an OR gate. The second case, I1, S1 is 0, S0 is 1. So S1 is 0. So 0 meaning it should be 1. So when this is 0, I need 1. So I connect the inversion of S1. And S0 is 1. So I connect S0 directly. And I1. Next, I2. I2, S1 is 1, S0 is 0. So S1 is 1, connect S1 directly. And connect, this is 0. So whenever you have a 0 here, I need to connect the inverted, I need to connect the inversion of the select line. So connect S0 bar and I2. And here, both of them are 1. So we connect S0, S1 and I3. So I bring I3 here. So connect all of them to the input of an OR gate and we get the output Y. So now let us see how this works. When S0 and S1 is 0, 0, right? Their inverted inputs are connected to the first AND gate. So these two are 1, right? So here, one of them would be 0, isn't it? Right? So when any one of the input is 0, I get a 0 here. And these two are 1. So when I0 is 0, I get a 0 here, output is 0. When I0 is 1, I get a 1 here, output is 1. So I0 is connected to the output. So in the next case, when S0 is 1 and S1 is 0, so we find that the inversion of S1 is connected to the AND gate. So this is 1, S0 is directly connected, this is 1, and I have I1 here. Okay, and one of these two inputs would be 0, so therefore the output of the AND gate would be 0 here. So definitely the output depends on I1. If I1 is 0, I get a 0 here, output is 0. If I1 is 1, I have a 1 here, so this is going to be 1 and I get 1 in the output. Right? So let's see the other two cases, which is indeed self-explanatory now. Right? So when S1 is 1 and S0 is 0, right? So S1 is directly connected, this is 1, its inversion is connected here, its inversion is connected, so this also is 1, okay, and here again any one of these inputs to the AND gate would be 0, so I will get 0, 0 and 0, so definitely output Y depends on I2, if I2 is 0, I get a 0 here, 0, if I2 is 1, I get a 1 here and 1 here. So similarly, when both of them are 1, these two are directly connected to this AND gate and one of these inputs would be 0. So the output of these three AND gates would be 0. Okay, and the output Y would depend on I3. I3 is 0, this is 0, Y is 0. I3 1, this would be 1 and Y is 1. Okay, so here in a multiplexer or a data selector, we are basically selecting one of the inputs to the output. Okay, and how is this selection done? This selection is done by using select lines. So in the next session, we will see more about multiplexers and demultiplexers.